due to despite of Karthikey Deepam, some students can't able to join with us now, but hope they will see this video in YouTube, ma'am.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, actually we forgot about it, otherwise we would have changed. Sorry about it. And
yes,
people can watch on YouTube. Yeah, go ahead.
How's about weather there, ma'am?
How is college?
Yeah, that's so good, ma'am.
okay. Weather, it's not snowing outside, but it's still it's 2 degrees Celsius outside.
2 degrees Celsius. Here there is heavy rain, ma'am.
Okay, you guys want to see? It's not snowing. It's just 2 degrees. It's not snowing yet.
Yes, ma'am. That sounds so chill.
Yeah, it's just people are. It's Sunday, so everything is closed. There's no snow. It's December, right? No, sorry. It's November last, and it's still not snowing.
Yeah. Ma'am, in December month, that's so hard to survive there, ma'am, because heavy snowfall right there, now.
Yes, that's right. It is going to be snowing, and it is hard when you come. But then as years pass by, you are going to love the snow. So it's not a big deal. Yeah. you can layer. Like I'm wearing a sweater and a lot of things. So
okay, ma'am. Can we start the session, ma'am?
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah, ma'am. Ma'am, tell me about yourself, ma'am. Actually, previously in Tamil session, you have already told about us, ma'am. But tell me about yourself, ma'am, briefly.
Yeah, actually, we already did this session in Tamil, but there were people who were asking in English. So we are doing the same, exact same session in English. So myself, my name is Soumya, and I'm from Coimbatore. Neelikonambalayam is my place, and I did nursing in RVS College of Nursing. I did by counseling, and then have 2 years of experience. Then I came to Canada. That's it. And I'm a registered nurse in Canada now here.
Wow, that's simply amazing, ma'am. Ma'am, did you know anything about Canada before you went there, ma'am?
No, actually, I don't know anything about Canada. I don't know why I chose Canada. I did not. Now people are asking a lot of questions, which I didn't do anything because of I did not have enough internet, and I don't have enough mobile or nothing. Right. So I just came with my own guts. Just believe in yourself and take a step and you can do it. The only reason I am saying this is when I came in the aeroplane, I didn't know where Canada and America was, right? I was just looking in the map, and okay, then I realized, okay, it's closer to America, and what am I going to do? I don't know anyone who is going to receive me in Canada. So while I can do it, you guys can do it. And remember, I will be here to receive you guys in Canada, okay?
Wow, that's really highly motivating, ma'am. Lots of guts is needed to do such a solo travel.
Just take a step ahead. Don't think a lot. If you keep thinking a lot, and you will not find answer for everything unless and until you just step.
That's a lag in that first step, ma'am. If the first step is taken out, then there will be a flow.
Exactly. The first step, like thinking twice or thrice, am I going to win? Will this happen? And so many questions in yourself. It is good to do a research, but don't test your own guts, right? Just start. Just give a try. So I didn't know anything.
To do research, ma'am?
Sorry, go ahead. Sorry?
Did you bother to do research, ma'am?
No. No, that's what I said. I didn't do any research. I didn't even know what courses I'm going to join, college, nothing. I was just so different. Yeah.
Your perspective is so different, ma'am. Ma'am, what made you to choose abroad, ma'am?
I didn't have any, honestly speaking, I didn't have any knowledge of military nursing service or JIPMER and AIMS, and a lot of Mumbai hospitals are giving a lot of salaries, you know. all I knew was like few hospitals around my house and like 7,000 INR, and I didn't know about the research and medical coding. There's a lot of categories in nursing. I didn't have a knowledge, and that is why I choose abroad. I'm saying this because I don't want people who is in India to feel down. There's a lot of opportunities in India to find in as a nurse. Abroad is also another perspective, but one strong point I love abroad is the way they respect the nurses is amazing here. That's a very strongest point, and I'm blessed to be here in Canada. Yes.
When did you start preparing, ma'am, and how, ma'am?
When did I start preparing? So IELTS is the first step, right? So IELTS I started in second year. So second year, Abdina, sorry. If it is second year, you don't have to think, oh, second year itself, I have to join college. I had a person who texted me, emailed me and asking, should I concentrate in nursing or should I concentrate in IELTS? You have to concentrate on both. You have to hard work and concentrate on both. Second year itself, I just started college, like with my friends, and I started reading newspapers. That is also an IELTS preparation. It's not, don't get worried about choosing an institution and going to an institution in spite of all your nursing requirements. It's okay. Even a small step is equal to preparing for IELTS. So if you speak in English, that is also preparation for IELTS, right? If you, there's apps which gives you like vocabulary every day, you know, like good morning Ajay, and it gives you one English word and then you learn that one word, and those are also small steps you take in English school, and you do a lot of messages and texting and all using the mobile, right? So use English, don't use Tamil
coming to English. Small step taking constantly will give more results than taking a big step occasionally.
Exactly. So these are the small steps which I took in second year, and slowly I joined in different. And also another question they ask us, which institute should I go? I really don't know. You won't believe me. I studied in 8 institute. I'm such a slow learner, and I don't know what's a reputed institute nowadays. So just go join an institute, and fourth year, when you just touch the fourth year, you have to be ready for IELTS. So this is the very first step I took, even before I'm knowing that I'm going to come abroad. Okay, if you're not coming, English is just a language, just know it, right? So it's okay.
Ma'am, you talked to us about IELTS, ma'am. What's the score we needed, ma'am, to go to come there?
So there's two categories. You come as a student visa. Through student, you need each six.
Nothing six we needed.
Also, I wanted to say, when you guys choose the college, just go into the college and check the requirement. They will mention the IELTS score. I know there are some people saying you don't need IELTS and you can just come and work here. There is a province called Quebec where they speak only French. Maybe those people don't need IELTS, but there is another language exam. There's another language exam for Quebec, which is for French. And the colleges which they are saying they don't need IELTS, they are going to make you study English in Canada, which is going to be expensive. So this is the little tip I'm giving you. People who are saying you can come here without IELTS, double check or kindly message me. I can also double check by calling the colleges. I'm definitely saying IELTS is the must, and 6 each and nothing less than 6 for student visa. For permanent residency, the higher you take, the higher you get the points. So they will categorize you for your age and for everything. You have points for your age, for your degree, for your English. So if in case you do high, like 7 each would be nice. That's for your permanent residency. permanent residency needs general IELTS, because I'm stressing this and saying slowly because there's a lot of questions, a lot of people who emailed me asking the same questions. So general IELTS is needed for permanent residency. Academic IELTS is needed for student visa. Okay? There's two type of IELTS.
Yeah, ma'am.
For example, when you come as a permanent resident here and then you are going to write nursing exam, you need academic IELTS. Yeah. Okay? Clear?
Ma'am, I have a doubt, ma'am. A student asked me before 2 to 3 days, ma'am. He asked me that, is there any type of visa that allows if he scores more than 80% in 12th English exam, they will allow to give student visa, that like stuff, ma'am?
Yeah, you're right. Actually, you're right. They do say that you can, if your 12th English score is higher, they do accept without IELTS. I tried for my own brother. He did score good, but what they said is our English syllabus is not that equal to your syllabus and they wanted to do the IELTS. This is not the case for everyone. Maybe my brother's English is not good, but you can give a try. You can give a try. There is a saying that when you do... English in 12th and you score high, there are colleges who accept, but I personally did not see, but you can give a try.
Which type of visa will you prefer, ma'am? Whether a PR or student visa, ma'am?
Yeah, this question also is asked by a few people. I am not able to answer that. The only reason is it depends on your situation. Let me say an example. One of my friend, Evelyn Hepzibah, she is such a nice friend of mine. She has a family. She has two kids and a husband who is doing a chemical engineering and she is a nurse. So if I say a student nurse for her, how is she going to come leaving the whole family and she's going to come here and study for 2 years and then work permit? You're going to separate from your family, right? And plus her age, and she has some break in her career too. So I think permanent residency is good for her, okay? So if some, like, a final year student is asking, and they are bachelor, they are single, and they can come as a student visa. So student visa processing time is only 20 business days once you got accepted letter. Permanent residency depends on your file. Okay, whoever takes your file, there are people who got permanent residency in 6 weeks. So I cannot give a straight answer directly in this session. But when you guys call me and say your situation, maybe I can suggest. But the financial requirements for both are same.
How much budget it takes, ma'am? Because the big fear is about that expenditure. They will have a lot of queries about that. How much budget, approximate budget will take to reach there and to initial expenses?
So as a permanent residency, when you come as a permanent residency, when you go to Google and type proof of funds for Canada permanent residency, just type the same way what I said. It's going to show the website and it will say how much you need. I think almost around, if a family of four, you need at least 10 to 12 lakhs, which you have to show in your bank account for 6 months. Okay. So you're not going to use it. They just want to make sure that you guys have money when you enter the Canada and you can survive the initial stages. That is the first thing. If you have a student visa, I know a few people who came, who applied loan and came here, and there are a few people who showed like 35 lakhs fund in their bank account and they did not apply loan. Okay, so roughly around, you have to pay the fees and plus you need at least 5 lakhs to come and survive here. As I said before, I came only with 40,000, but now the rules is you have to enter with 5 lakhs. Okay, like a guaranteed income certificate. It's not a must that you have to use. If you get a part-time job, you can send it back to the family. So 5 lakhs for each person you need.
What's the initial step we have to take, ma'am? Example, I'm a graduate. I'm graduated. What should be the first step I have to take, ma'am?
IELTS. IELTS is your first step. Second is start surfing through internet and see which college suits you. There is another video I did last week saying that how many specialties we have, and you guys go through the colleges in Canada, you select the courses and you call me and I will say you what course is okay. And also you have to make sure there's a lot of practical hours. So first do IELTS, second select a course. You can come with experience or without experience. Don't waste time. Go join a local hospital while you're doing IELTS. And if you're coming as a permanent residency, talk with your hubby or your family members. And if they're doing permanent residency, that's a separate line. So whatever line you choose, it's IELTS is the first step. IELTS is the first step, and start doing research side by side.
Ma'am, many of them have a big fear regarding NCLEX, ma'am. Please explain about that exam, ma'am. What is NCLEX, ma'am?
Yeah, NCLEX is an exam which we write to become a licensed nurse in Canada. Actually, it was CRNE, which I wrote, and it's only for Canada. Now you guys are lucky, it's NCLEX, and you can work in Canada and America. So one exam, you can work in both the places. And it is not that hard. It is very easy. Once you start taking your nursing subject seriously, like for in case if you're doing the final year, you concentrate more on the patient's care. You know, like as I said in the Tamil session, like for in final year, you just explain a pregnant lady why, for this is just an example. Just think the pregnant lady's leg is so swollen. You just go say, go lift your leg up, and that's not the way you do. You have to understand why the leg is swollen, right? Because the baby is compressing the inferior vena cava, so the venous return is slow, so that is why the leg is swollen. So you explain them you don't have to use the medical words, but use simple words and explain them. And every time and every nursing management you explain and do to each patient, it's going to register. And that is the question they are asking in NCLEX. All they want to know is, are you having a critical knowledge behind it? Like, it would be a simple question like, why the pregnant lady's leg is swollen, right? If you know the anatomy behind it, the uterus has compressed the inferior vena cava, you're going to pass the mark, you're going to get the mark. So, and the professional standards too. So it's easy, very easy when you do your nursing, when you start from day one, nursing college, get a close connect to the patient and the nursing management. It's going to be easy for NCLEX. So people who are watching, who's working and watching, you know what, like after 4 or 5 years nursing, it would be like 4 or 5 years. They did 2005 batch or 10 batch. It's okay. There's a lot of NCLEX tutoring center. You can go there and 2 or 3 months, you're going to hit the exam. It's not that hard. Lots of people have passed. There's only 3 chances. So you can do it. It's okay. If you don't do it the first chance, they are giving you a course here. And if you fail on the second chance too, there's another course for 6 months. So I think you can do it. But
ma'am, NCLEX, writing NCLEX in India and coming to Canada, what do you think about that, ma'am?
I think you can write, but when you apply NNAS, there's a video I made for NNAS. When you apply for NNAS, if they give you eligibility right away when you guys are in India, it's a golden opportunity. Actually, do the NCLEX there and apply for a permanent residency. You're going to get the permanent residency right away because they see you have passed the NCLEX exam. Come here, start working. But I have never seen such a kind of people there here. Maybe there are people, I don't know, but yes, it is possible. Yes,
ma'am, there are lots of courses are there for our PG or diploma something, ma'am. There is a great confusion. What should we select after our BSc nursing? Which course is better and we can earn as soon as possible?
No. There's nothing like that. As I said here, everything, they pay you equally, right? IV nurse. You're just doing IV. You're going to go to a clinic at 9 to 5. You start an IV. And there are some immunosuppressants and a lot of drugs. So they give only IV. And she gets paid the same as I get when I work in ICU. And same who's working in the child health nursing. And the same who's a public health. It's pay same here. Go ask yourself, go towards your passion. Like, which subject do you like, Ajay? What subject do you like?
Medical surgical, ma'am.
Yeah, then go with the medical surgical. That's it. You guys are going to get paid same everywhere. But I know in Canada, they don't differentiate you. Even you go to the long-term care, they pay you the same. So somebody wants to, I don't remember the name. He wants to be a surgical nurse. Yeah, go ahead and do a perioperative nursing course and excel. Ask yourself what skills you have and excel in that.
Wow, that sounds great, ma'am. Ma'am, what is the scope of other paramedical professionals such as pharmacists, physios, operation theater technicians? What are the scopes for them, ma'am? Whether there is a scope right there, ma'am?
Anything and everything you do in medical, you guys have an amazing life here. Anything and everything you do in medical, it can be a lab technician. Lab technician earn a lot more than a nurse. Physio earn a lot. Physiotherapist earn a lot. Occupational therapist, yes. Occupational therapist is a huge career. I do see Kiran Kumar is asking, I'm pursuing OT and anesthesia tech second year. What can I do next? Can you guide me? OT and anesthesia tech, There is a life here. All you have to do is, you're just a student, right? Start searching for consultants. No, start searching for colleges which is supporting your career, and go through the requirements and see what you need. Give me a call. Email me. People who email me know that I have replied each and every one, and I will definitely guide you. Yes, there is a life. Okay.
Yeah.
For all, because, for everything. Even if you do biotechnology, anything in biology.
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, pharmacist. Yes, pharmacist. Holy moly, pharmacist! You guys are the richest person. It's $70 per hour. $70, 3,500 Indian rupees per hour.
Wow, that's really huge amount, ma'am.
Yeah, pharmacists are 6 years. They do 6 years like a doctor's here. They are respected as doctors. A doctor cannot order any drug without consulting a pharmacist. Not even a simple drug. If he is going to write dopamine, a pharmacist is going to come and talk with you as a nurse, talk with me and say all the side effect, will explain. And then pharmacist also will come and explain. So it's a huge role. When I talk about pharmacist, it's a huge role. And you're going to be a millionaire if you come here, pharmacist. Okay.
Welcome, Mohan, the pharmacist millionaire.
Yeah, I know. Right? It's hard. Everything needs, you guys have to pass exams. Okay, physiotherapy has an exam. Nursing has an exam. Everything.
Yeah, I think C-plex. Am I right, ma'am?
Sorry?
C-plex, the exam name C-plex, I'm thinking so.
Maybe, I think so, yeah. I'm not that sure, yes.
Because I have formed a friend.
Okay.
He talked about that, but he told me like that, that's really a very toughest exam. We can't go through that. And there are three exams, I'm thinking so, to enter now.
People will fail in the exams, right? So that is why I say, take your studies seriously while you can, right? The 4 years, don't waste your time and take it seriously. Everything is application, but they're not going to ask straightly what causes myocardial infection. No. What are you going to do, right? What are you going to do? Everything is practical. So if you do the 4 years nursing, you can easily pass the exam. Student, when you are as a student, come here as a student visa. Your memory is going to be fresh. Don't waste your time in India. And come right away, fresh off the bat. You write the exam, pass it, and you will earn.
Yeah, ma'am. Ma'am, a student asked that, Ma'am, I have a doubt. My brother told to physician associate in London, ma'am. But is there any course available in like MSc in anesthesia? Can you please describe? I can't get
anything. Physician associate in London, ma'am. But is there any course available like MSc in anesthesia? Wa? MSc in anesthesia, I don't know. I don't think so. I know there is a, if as a nurse, I'm a nurse, right? If I pursue like peri anesthesia certificate, I can go help the anesthetist. And anesthetist is a doctor and a nurse myself who pursued a peri anesthesia course. And I don't want to say, as far as my knowledge, there's nothing called MSc anesthesia. If I can Google it up, and I'll Google King's Engine 97. Email me after the session. Let me go search and I'll call you.
Yeah, that sounds amazing, ma'am. Ma'am, next the thing is, actually, you are really an inspiration, ma'am. You are guiding us more. You are helping us more. If anyone take the first step today, that means going for IELTS, do you help in applying, ma'am? It's a great help you can do for us, ma'am.
Yeah, applying for student visa and applying for permanent residency. Actually, myself and my husband were talking because my friend Evelyn did say about a consultancy. So we were talking, and plus few more people did ask me about, can you apply for student visa? Yes, we can apply. Okay, yes, we can apply. Am I going to charge you? I don't know. My aim is to bring at least 5 people in Canada. If I bring at least 5 people in Canada, that's going to be my success of starting my YouTube channel and my passion. Because I have I am enjoying all the benefits. I wanted everyone there, out there, who has no knowledge, want to come here. I want them to be here and enjoy this, right? So if the volume is getting increased, because I'm not going to do any paperwork, it's my husband. I cannot apply for PR or student visa. It's a huge process, but my husband can, because we have applied for our family and for friends. I'm not going to say that I won't charge anything, but I won't charge only if Ajay comes to Canada and I see he is living fine, then I will charge you money. Okay, if you apply and you're not getting anything and you're stuck in India, I'm not going to get a penny from you. Okay, you understand, I don't want to do as a business. Plus, I don't want to bug my husband. I can do a service, but my husband, I can't ask my whole family to do a service. But only I should see anyone like Jai Jyothi or Neil Suresh or Mohan Vijayanarayanan, Vichy Bucks, Smiley, whoever, like 17 people are watching, whoever, you guys come here, I will apply for you. But when you come in Canada and you call from the Canadian number, then we will chat about it. Okay, I'm not going to ask like maybe like 20,000 per person or 15. I don't know. I have never, ever thought about that. I don't know. And I also don't want to say no, because what if like 15 people are applying, right? It is a lot of work. And once I have to ask my husband, he's also working. So, but take it seriously. Come here. I will help you in everything. But I wanted you guys to come here. Come here and pursue a career. I'm going to be here and then we can talk. Okay.
Wow, maybe you guys really can have great coffee service,
okay?
So kind of you.
For me, for my whole family. You guys come here. Ma'am, if we get a chance to get a job in Canada, is there any language barrier occurring for us? When you do IELTS, there's no language barrier. And when I started nursing, like first job in Canada, I did as an ICU nurse. I didn't have a clue what the patient was saying, right? I was just standing here, standing and nodding my head. Okay. I don't know what pardon is. You know, there's a joke, pardon me. Do you know what pardon me is?
Pardon me.
Pardon me.
Excuse me. Yeah,
right? So I don't know, pardon. Right? I know what is pardon, but I don't know how they pronounce it. I'm thinking they're calling someone. And I was turning, okay, there's no one named Pardon. And I have done so much stupid things. But in couple as days go by, you're going to pick the accent and you're going to be good. It's not a barrier at all. You are going to do IELTS, so it is not a barrier. French and English is the national language in Canada. And a lot of Canadians don't know French. And you don't have to know French. Just know English and come here and you can survive. Okay?
Yeah, that's great. Ma'am, a student asked that, can we pursue our PG in Canada? Whether it is valued in India, ma'am? Doing a PG in Canada is valued in India.
India, lala, because they will take you like that.
Indian degree, they are not valuating in Canada. Why should Indians evaluate Canadian degree in India?
That is India. Can we pursue our PG in Canada whether it's valued in India? Of course, of course. They are going to pay you a lot. And when you pursue, I'll say you something, Roger Ben 05. When you do masters here and when you have a Canadian citizen here and when you go for Abu Dhabi or any UAE countries, they're going to pay you by passport. So if Ajay goes to Dubai and I go to Dubai with the Canadian passport, we both are working in the same floor, he's going to get 2 lakhs and I'm going to get 2 into 3, 6 lakhs. Same floor, same job, same patient, but his passport is Indian passport and my passport is Canadian passport. So they recognize the Western education greatly and India, yes, of course, they're going to do it. Ma'am, oh, are you in Canada? Shakti Ishwar 04, yes, I am in Canada. See, I am in Canada. What else?
Old right there now, ma'am.
Neil Suresh has asked MLT question mark. What is MLT?
Medical lab technology, ma'am.
Oh yeah, lab technology also earn a lot, right? Lab technicians are, I don't know what their salary is. But I do know they earn a lot. Somewhat same around the nurses, like 2.5-3 lakhs per month.
Okay, ma'am. Nice, ma'am. Then, ma'am, what's your thought, ma'am, about nursing? That's really an interesting question.
Nursing is amazing. Such a blessing. Watch my videos. Nursing is it's the way you look. If you look, ma'am, I want to come to Canada. Yes, Suji Smith.
Yeah, welcome.
Welcome to Canada. Maybe if you guys come to Toronto, I will come and pick you guys, okay? So nursing is a blessing. What I think, number one, a lot of people are doing a lot of courses and searching for jobs. For us, the job opportunity is amazing, either in India or either in abroad. Even in abroad, I moved to different places. I have moved to different 8 different places, but I get job everywhere, right? Just in case, for example, I bought a house here. It's so cheap in this city, Windsor. My husband was afraid to move here because he's going to get a job. But I was okay to come here because there is a hospital here and you get a job here, right? So that's one thing. Job opportunity is amazing. And serving, this might be a little dramatic, but serving a patient is, serving is an amazing way of leading your life. When you get some positive thoughts from your patients or anybody, it's going to be when you go to bed and sleep, you feel that, yes, I did something. I did change someone's life, right? I think nursing will do, like, will bring the patients who come and admit have a lot of questions in their mind, a lot of fears. Think yourself as a patient. You're going to know their position. And when the nurse-client relationship is amazing, you're going to love the profession more. When they give respect, when the doctors give respect. Nursing now, and the, oh my God, nobody is going to respect me. It's such an ill-spoken profession in India, I know. But we as a student, we as a nurses have to change the way they look. You guys, when you go to the ward, like when you go for the student posting, chuma getta ponga, don't ever think that, oh, nursing, okay, time planning, the same shit, same thing. Or when you do even the oral care, please do with dedication. It might be sounding dramatic, but once you do, okay, in back you think why you do the oral care and think also about the NCLEX. There might be a question in NCLEX for the oral care too, right? So when you read it, think that you're going to work in abroad and rationalize yourself. with passion, with critical thinking, you're going to love nursing. You're going to love nursing like anything. Nursing is such an amazing opportunity. When you come out, you're going to fly in colors, and you have to prove yourself. Please don't let it go. Like, you know, when your neighbors and when your family members have asked you a question, why you took nursing, you have to prove that this is why I took the nursing and I'm earning money and I'm sad. So please don't put down the nursing. I love nursing like anything. I love nursing like anything.
Wow, that sounds so great, ma'am. Let me go for a Q&A session, ma'am. Students, you can ask your doubts and questions to our ma'am regarding PR or visa processing or anything related to Canada.
I think we read till Jay Jodi Ravichandran. Thank you so much, ma'am. Suji Smith, I want to come Canada. Yeah, welcome. Kutti Selva, ma'am, my sister want work in Singapore. I don't have knowledge about Singapore, but I know one of the person who watched this page contacted me. He is working in Singapore and he wanted to come Canada. Email me, Kutti Selva. I will give his contact so you and him can speak. So you may know how to work in Singapore. Which hospital is good? You mean in Canada or in India? In Canada, every hospital is good. Every hospital is government hospital. There's no private hospital. Sri Ram 2019. Ma'am, India la irundhu IELTS exam eludhala amma. Amma. IELTS exam, you should write in India.
India.
You should write in India.
Ma'am, what's your hospital name, ma'am, you're working in?
I'm working in Nunavut. Okay. My hospital name is Quick. It's not an English name. It's not an English name, okay? I'm going to...
French, ma'am? Whether it is French?
It is. It's not French. It's an Inuit language. So, if you know the First Nations, now on the... I cannot say in the social media. It's called Kwikitman. I don't know, man. Kwikitchinimanik Hospital, okay? May I have your email ID? SoumyaRN.Canada.
Roger, you can contact ma'am in email ID, otherwise with her YouTube channel, Tamil Nurse Soumya. You can check it out with YouTube, Tamil Nurse Soumya. Ma'am will continuously posting videos regarding Canada procedures and everything.
Yeah, toxic ma'am, toxic. If I want to work in Canada, experience is necessary or not? No, you can come with experience or you cannot come with experience. But the National Nursing Council is going to assess your file. And if you don't have experience, probably they're going to ask you to do something. What are the procedures we need to do work in Canada? IELTS, apply for NNAS, pass, write the NCLEX exam, pass the exam, and you're a nurse.
Yeah, the ma'am have detailedly explained that in a video.
Yeah.
This is uploaded in YouTube, both in Tamil Nurse Soumya and Medic Boy vlogs.
Because
you can check it out with that.
Yeah, it's a big question, right? Yeah. Okay, and hi for everyone who said hi, hello, thank you. Thank you so much. I hope I meet every single person here in Canada. Okay, please don't. Consistency is important. Okay, when your thought wants to come into action, consistency. Don't simply start the IELTS and drop it in 1 month. Keep on fighting with it. If you want to pursue a dream, you have to keep fighting with it. Okay? Don't drop a walk. If you have done once IELTS and if you didn't get the score, don't drop it. Do it again. Do it again. Stop not till you achieve the goal, right? Consistency is important. Okay? Thank you, ma'am. IELTS exam, eppadi ma'am appear pandrathu? That is again a big question. Okay? Go online. IELTS, there's a lot of websites which say you that. Can we do our specialty in Canada, ma'am? Like, I am interested in doing pediatrics. Is it possible? Yes, you come in Canada. You come to Canada. You get a registered nursing license. And when you do master's, it is not like med surg or psychiatry or பீடியாட்ரிக் அப்படி இல்ல, இட்ஸ் நாட் லைக் தட் இன் கனடா. மாஸ்டர்ஸ் இன் நர்சிங், எதர் யூ பிகம் அ நர்ஸ் பிராக்டிஷனர் ஆர் யூ கோ டு அ எஜுகேஷன் லைன். ஓகே, இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் டு டீச், இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் டு டீச் த ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், யூ கோ டு த எஜுகேஷன் லைன். இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் டு பிகம் அ நர்ஸ் பிராக்டிஷனர், யூ ஹாவ் அ கிளினிக் அண்ட் யூ ரன் த கிளினிக். அதுல இன் தட் இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் டு சூஸ் ஓன்லி சைல்ட் யூ கேன். ஓகே, whether English language alone is enough to survive in Canada, yes it is. There is another national language, French, but English is just enough. Okay, ma'am, are you a BSc nurse? I'm just a BSc nurse. Ma'am, exam eludina mattum dan job accept pannuvaangala ma'am? Yes, wonderful question, Jayajyothi Ravichandran. Actually people say that we will get you job in abroad. Don't trust them. You may work as a nurse, maybe as a caregiver, you know. Registered nurse is the top, who's going to manage you everything. Registered licensed nurse, licensed practical nurse or registered licensed nurse, whatever they call, is one step next to the BSc nursing. It's a practical nursing. They're going to give medications and other stuffs, manage other stuffs in the ward. Adhikku keela, the next step is personal support worker, PXW, who are going to bath the patient, change the dress, change the brief, change the bed. So when people advertise in India that even without the exam will make you to work as a nurse, they will make you to work in the below category, you know, like changing PXW. Changing the sheet and stuff and changing everything. So you have to write an exam to be a nurse. You definitely have to write an exam. For Canada, which exam you need to write? NCLEX. NCLEX for Canada, one exam for both the Canada and America. NABH certificate hospital work panna mattum dhaan Canada or other countries ku poga mudiyuma? Actually, NABH certificate is must, but I don't know what, I don't think so.
Any working in any hospital?
Yeah, any hospital. They check how many hours. And when you submit the job experience to the nursing council, Divya, they are going to call the dean of the hospital and they're going to ask, is there anything problem with you? And how the experience is? And how many bedded hospital, right? That is more important. How many bedded hospital will teach you, will show how big experience you have.
Yeah, ma'am. Need of experience is must for Canada.
No. It is good. It is an advantage if you have an experience. Even if you come as a student, fresher, they will say you. Any kind of file they can accept. Yeah.
That's what I can say. I think that's all the questions I'm thinking so much. Really a great session, ma'am.
I think we have covered everything.
The first step, yes, ma'am. Our students don't stop just by listening this, and they don't want to stop the thing. See? Want to take the
you
first step
because
more finally
students
are there. This is a good opportunity to them. They have to take their first step, and they should come upon. Protocol.
Ma'am, can you share about the procedures, protocols? It's different from Indian protocol for holding the hospital. Yes, it is totally different. It cannot be what simpler. If I want to say simply, for an let me say an example, you work as what nurse? Okay, you work as a delivery nurse because he is doing the final year nursing. It's a one-on-one. So if I am the patient who is going to deliver, and if he is the nurse, he is responsible for everything. There's no doctor. The doctor comes only at the time of the delivery. Okay? So he has to take care of, he has to measure the contraction. He has to titrate the oxytocin if you are giving oxytocin. He has to do the PV check. He has to prepare for everything like a cross-matching also he has to do, and all the antenatal assessment he has to do. He has to read the monitor, he has to read the ECG when the mom has ECG connected. He has to get ready for the baby, he has to know the CPR for baby, like neonatal compressions you have to know. You have to know everything. That's no helping hands for you. Nurses are everything here. And it's a different way, man. There's no procedures and protocols. All you have to know is you need knowledge. And thank you so much for explanation. Thank you, ma'am. It's a wonderful session. Keep doing, ma'am. Thank you so much. Do you guys have any doubts at all, or shall it's all done? Is there anything I have to cover, Abjai? I don't think so.
I think we have covered maximum everything topics, ma'am. If they have any doubts regarding that, they can contact in your YouTube channel or in mail ID, ma'am.
Yes, you can. Yes. I have to call some. I think Archana or someone wanted to call me. I have to call. Compare in Tamil Nadu standardization and respect to nurses is better for nurses. Of course. Tamil Nadu, I don't know what standard they are giving. It all depends on Tamil Nadu is it depends on how you are, right? If Ajay is also working as a nurse and I'm also working as a nurse, if he is good, all the patients are going to like him. And if I don't, they don't like me. And the sister, kadakrapo, abdina. Okay, right? And amma vandale talavali. That is how Tamil Nadu is. But here it is not like this, because you will change. Everyone gives respect, takes respect, and you will gain respect. The standardization is amazing, to the point. Respect is great. Even in the car number plate, they write as a registered nurse. You know the doctors will put the plus symbol and say I'm a doctor. In India they do that, right? In Canada, my nursing plate can be like Saumya, the registered nurse, RN. So and they get to here.
That sounds really great, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. I think we have covered maximum topics.
Yeah.
If there is any doubt, they can contact
working
you.
Working hours in Canada, 40 hours. 40 hours per week only, and only when you like 7:30 to 7:30 if it is a 12-hour shift, and 7:35 if the time has prolonged, because when you're giving report, when the handover has happened till for 15 minutes, they will pay you twice, double time for 15 minutes.
Wow.
Even for 5 minutes, they will pay you double time. Okay.
Yeah, we can do OT right there,
no? OT, yeah. Not much. When I was single, I do OT every now and then. Always overtime. Overtime is time and a half. All the public holidays are time and a half. And there are provinces which pay you double time. So $36 per hour, my salary now. Time and a half is calculate. And double time is like Labor Day, Canada Day and all. I think it's double time. So 36 plus 36.
Yeah.
Per hour.
So that's really a huge amount, man. Yeah, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Let me end up the session, ma'am. Ma'am,
yeah.
Sarma, ma'am, asked about your health, ma'am. When I went to the college, she really appreciated me and you, ma'am.
Thank you so much. She's such a sweetheart. She's also one inspiration, right? The way she has her haircut, the way she wears the sari. I used to admire everything. The way she talks, the way she smiles when she comes into. She was a vice principal when I was there. Oh my God, you have to be like that. Yes, right? The attire.
Yeah.
Say a huge thanks to her. She's also one huge inspiration. Another Shubha ma'am. Simple NCLEX questions, like CGFNS questions, she will throw. Like she may teach only like appendicitis or something, but she will give like 10 questions of CGFNS for America. So when you do that 10 question, and when you score like 6 out of 10, when you're just second year nursing or third year nursing, you know how confidence you get? Oh, I think I have that capacity, right? Maybe I should do something to go achieve that goal. So teachers like that are amazing. Like they will pick your ability and show.
Yeah,
It's amazing.
Very good teacher our college had.
RVS is amazing. In Canada, common nurse or specialized nurse for different procedures. Common nurse. Any common nurse can do a thing, but specialized procedures now. You know, you can. Do you know who asked that question? Sink, SJINK. Like peripherally inserted catheter, PICC line. Do you guys know PICC line? Like peripherally inserted catheter, they do in the jugular vein, like here. Do you know that? There's a central vein which doctors do. There's a peripherally inserted catheter. Like people who get who wants to take like 6 weeks of antibiotic or 8 weeks of antibiotic have peripherally inserted catheter. So even they do. The nurses insert that. Okay. So those things need a specialized nurse. So if you go for a dialysis, if you deal with the dialysis, those things need a specialized nurse. But not everything needs a specialized nurse. A very specific procedure needs a specialized nurse. Ma'am, starting $36 starting in $36 salary, ma'am. Each province has a different salary. Okay, this province has $30. Ontario has $30. Alberta has $34. So minimum $30. Average $30. Okay, each province has a Nunavut, which is up north, starting is $45.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, I think we should end this session.
Yeah, ma'am. Thank you so much for your time, ma'am. That's really a great session. We gained a lot of knowledge and guided with full satisfaction. We are going to end this session, ma'am. Lots of students gained regarding lots of ideas to Canada. Yeah, ma'am. Hope we will meet soon.
Yeah. Anything. Yeah, I don't know what the live session next going to be, so you can contact me. People who are like me, who are in abroad, please do live sessions with Ajay like this. Many
Thank
people
so
can
much.
Gain knowledge. It's only like half an hour or what, 45 minutes of your time is going to enlighten and change someone else's life. So just spend some time, please. I am contacting a lot of people. Please do some video, but I know they're busy, right? They're busy with the family and stuff. So. Okay, anyhow, thank you so much. Bye, everyone.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah.
See you soon. Bye, ma'am.
Yeah. Bye. 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 Bye.
Bye.
Up to.